Hey guys, it is me. That was Freshly. I am back again with I guess, a quick rundown of the features of the Zoom. Someone asked me, and like I said, there's a lot of noobs who don't know about PhoneDog and stuff, and they just happen to stumble upon me. So me being the most blunt, probably Android guy out there who just uses plain English and hates to use technical terminology when describing Android tablets because it's just a tab. Basically, there you go. So let's get into it. As we, I showed you before, this is the notification tablet. The settings is in here. It's always going to be there. You see settings. I'm just going to tap it. Now, someone asked me this in the comment on my review. So you guys, I'm going to have to tilt this up a lot and tilt it back a lot. Because I'm using a regular webcam, not an HD cam. I don't have a tripod and all the extra stuff. I'm not a normal reviewer. Okay, so someone asked me about the keyboard, so we're gonna go down to language and keyboard. Yes, see, language settings. We're gonna select language settings. You have English, Espanol, and French. User dictionary, voice recognizer settings, text to speech settings, your input method. I have it on always show, so it's always down there in the corner. Every time the keyboard pops up, it's always there. Angry Bird shows up like extremely well. I'll give you guys a quick test run. I'm in the dark because I discovered that this tablet actually shows a lot better in the dark. This is Angry Bird Rio, so let's go. I'm just gonna show you guys a level. You guys can see the detail. I mean, this is crazy. Uh-oh. Wow. Are you serious? So, as you can see, pinch to zoom works very well on here. So I'm gonna pull it back. You see there's no lag, anything. So let's shoot for. Go, Johnny, go, Johnny, go! Wow, and I wasn't even trying. Let's get out of this. Okay. So, back out. Originally, let's see, nothing really works for this tablet yet. There aren't many, there's probably honestly maybe about 30 to 40 optimized tablet application. Most of them don't work on the Zoom. However, SwiftKey does have a beta keyboard. Let's show that. We'll open up. Let's see. We'll open this up. So we're gonna go right here to where I told you I always show keyboard settings. You change your input method to SwiftKey Beta. Now they've modeled this after Honeycomb, and there you go. The prediction is not great. And you see, I am a beautiful person. Which I am. Okay. Once again, the clock widget I have, it does not come with a clock widget. This clock widget is made by Fancy Widgets Pro. So pretty much that's the gist of it. It doesn't come one when you click it. Has a sense-like excuse me, oh my God, implementation of the moving weather animation. As you can see, the weather sucks here in Atlanta. Right now, it's WrestleMania weekend. Woohoo! I'll show you the music player again. Like I said, I went over this before, but I like to just dedicate some time to it. And there you go. Now, I'm scared to play anything because, like I said, they really have tried to get on me about playing music. So what I will do is find a song that's by a friend of mine and play it. without them being able to say anything because they don't know him enough. They okay, we'll just play a beat. I don't know if you guys hear the sound. I move it up. Yeah, it's great. There's even like a little sub bass in here. It's weird. So at any given time, you'll see these headphones in the corner. Now, as you can see, shout out to Vi Beats, one of the best producers on the internet. Google him. I hit the headphone, takes me back to that view. Now if I hit him again, I can change the view again. Now you see where it says albums. I can change the view and go to new and recent, which is gonna take me to the tab view. And it's showing me the most recent that I've played. So now I'm gonna play. So, there you go. Yeah, because I realized that's my friend's song also, but it's a sample, and I don't want to get in trouble again, YouTube. That's horrible. But let's keep going. Once again, there's a widget for your market. This is the market widget. It just basically shows you the market stuff. So, let me see if I can unhook this camera and move this thing around for you guys so you guys can see. I'm gonna move it around. There we go. This is the, you can see what it does. This is kind of neat. My widget for here stopped doing anything. So, I mean, but what I can do is look at my channel, which is Elvis Freshly, and look at my videos, which is my Huawei Idios review, my Motorola Zoom unboxing and review, blah, 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 and T-Mobile Vibrant review. I review a lot of devices on here, but I do them after everyone else because I do them when I feel like it. I don't feel pressured to be the first one to do it because I do it for fun. This is actually fun for me. If you don't like it, I don't really care how proper you think I should be doing it because you're not me. So, okay. Let's get them back leveled out, and you're probably bad. So, maps rocks. It takes a minute to load sometimes. Okay, let's zoom out and let's go. I'm gonna go to, let's see where I wanna go. Let's go to Michigan. Let's go to, let's see, let's, where do we wanna go in Michigan? Let's go to Detroit. There's Detroit. You can see I'm zooming in on Detroit. Look how close it's getting. This is crazy. Just for me doing a United States view. Now, this is where it gets kind of nice. I'm going to throw some. Okay, so here we go. We're in Detroit. So, let's try this. Okay, so now we're all the way in Detroit. Let's hit it like this. You take two fingers, and you see I can hit a whole nother view. So let's see. Let's try it again. It's dope. I can actually take it. Hello. Turn the whole city around without turning the damn tablet around. Hold on. As you can see, I can look at any building in a 360 degree view. So now if I want to say, well, what building is this? The names of the buildings are there. This is the Wayne County Human Resources Building. Isn't this like amazing? And I can go back this way. No, I can't. Yes, I can. And flatten it back out and look back at it from a flat version. And see, here we go from a more, you know. And we zoom back up. With two fingers, you zoom out. So, you guys get the gist of maps. Once again, the market, if you haven't seen the market, it's the same as the phones, except this thing is even sweeter, and it's just like one continuous long-ass looping bar. So, basically that's what you're getting. It moves by itself. You have categories now over here. As you can see, they're moving on the right-hand side of the screen. You can also go by top free, top browse. You know, it's just formatted better the way it should have been formatted. Calendar widget is really nice. It's telling me April Fool's Day is coming. I don't know why you would like to tell me that like it's a real holiday, but I appreciate that. You have your browser bookmarks that are there. You have contacts in here for some reason. This is the Wi-Fi only version. Why, I don't know. But I'm sure there's some strange reason for it. Now, this is Friendcaster. It sucks, really. I mean, it works all right, but all you can do is really post from it. You can't go searching and stuff. Pretty much all these apps work. Like I said, Tango, you'll be upside down if you use it. They can see you. You can see them quite fine. But once again, as I said, you'll be upside down to them. So you have to hold the tablet upside down, which makes them upside down. The orientation does not adjust itself. So you'll be kind of, you know, butt-cheeked out. There's an app on here that I really like. Real Will Wrap for Crack. You can literally just draw on this thing, see? And I don't know why, what your actual use would be for that, but like I say, movie studio, you can make a full movie with your Zoom. With your Zoom, all you have to do is, long story short, video record in sections and piece it together, and you have a movie. Okay. Everything else on here is standard. I mean, except for the games. QWERTY comes with it, which is really nice. You can get QWERTY on the mobile phone also, though. And so can you get Dungeon Defenders. I don't play that game because it's rather complicated for a tablet. And I'm not into gaming on the tablets. Like I say, there's no buttons. So it's like when you're playing the game, it's like rather, you know, butthole-ish. It's like, why am I playing this? Because I have no keys to play anything with. And you're using the on-screen keys, and it doesn't work well. Vivo, I've never used Vivo with this, ever. So clearly, there is no, once again, as we can see, there is no landscape. So let's try. Okay, I'm not going to show you guys a video on Vivo because, once again, I don't want to get sued. And I don't want my channel shut down. So, see? Sometimes you will get a delay like that. That's only normal, you know, that you get a delay like that. Your Gmail app is your widget. Like I say, it's tilted. Like you see, Engadget opens up sideways again, but then it readjusts itself. So this is Engadget Mobile. Pretty cool. That's pretty much the best you'll get out of this. Elvis Freshly, if you guys have any more questions, I'll answer them. But pretty much, I'm just floating right now, guys. So anything else you need, just let me know. Appreciate the views and everyone subscribing. I'm going to do Ask Elvis Freshly next. So if you have any questions for Ask Elvis Freshly, leave them below. Thanks, guys. Have a good one.